Okay, down here. I'm just trying to get. Oh, there we go. Yes, it did move on me. Okay, refrigerator. I made a video about the ice maker not working, leaking all over, not working right. And I decided after research that I should replace the water inlet valve. Not sure how far to get here. Got one, and it's actually not a real big job. Hopefully everything will go real smooth. Look at the papers again real quick. Let's see if there's anything I forgot. Let's see. Oh yeah, it tells you the difference between a couple of different models. And there's a plastic line. If it has a little compression nut on it, then it says just, well, it'll tell you what to do. I'm not reading it, so I don't know. Just looking at the picture. But I don't believe mine has a nut on it. It just has a sort of a compression fitting, but it's just you stick the hose in there and it's supposed to stack. As long as your hose is the right size, and everything's good. That would be my one thing that I won't know till on the other one. It's threaded and it connects to the, I have some metal braided flex hose, water hose, that should fit that fitting there perfectly. Oh yeah, forgot to get my, oh, you don't want Teflon tape on that, it'd probably just get in the way. It's a compression fitting too. So all I should have to do is, I'm just going to put that, just laying that there to keep from Yeah, this is my second chore today, so I'm already tired. Okay, so I'm gonna put the door open so that I can move this thing around. I'm gonna put the door and get in and out to get tools and stuff. Yeah, I want to get an extension cord. I've got a 30 amp extension cord. I just happen to have one. I've already plugged in out there that you usually use a heater on. Of course, it's warm weather now. We don't need it. So I'm going to get that ready. I'm going to unplug the refrigerator and plug it into that so that we won't be losing cool. We got a refrigerator. Everything's cool. Yeah, of course we don't have it on a 30 amp circuit, it's just a 15 amp circuit, but that means the wires are big enough they can handle, you know, like a 1500 watt heater. Otherwise, you'll melt a regular extension cord. So, last time it was. Mostly empty and it came out real loosey. But I got it. Luckily my water hose is long. So, here's the thing. I'm going to be working down here, so. Let's just put it in the floor for now, and then I'll move it again in a minute. That's where we're going to be working, in that area. Turkey was leaking a lot. The water's been off for a few days already. So, let me get leave the camera there until I get to that thing. It didn't come on, so I think it's on. Make sure the doors were shut good. Oh, I might have a little bit of water wanting to leak. Get rid of that. Last time there really wasn't hardly any leaking going on. Okay. First I gotta get this cover off of here. Well, first I'll get the hose off. Thank you. It's not very tight, so I think this is it'd be better to get an in wrench. I just forgot that. Let you go get it. Trying to get out my knee out of the way. I do have to get here to work. Glad I got the in wrench. That's a little far over. Okay. Now, I thought I might stick that hose in that bucket, but I don't. Yeah. I gotta put it somewhere. Super. If it'll stay in there, maybe. Okay. Now I'm gonna take the cover off and then I'll get up close on the water. That's the water inlet valve down there. That's what turns the water on and off going to the ice maker. And I believe, I thought it was bad actually, and when I tested it, it did not beep on my own meter, so I thought the electrical was bad. And I thought, well, I'm going to test the new one when I get it. Well, it don't beep either. So I think I just wasn't, probably didn't have it set right, sensitive enough or something. I'm not real good with that. I can use the beep, but that's the rest of it. I haven't bothered to learn enough about. I don't do that kind of thing that often enough. So anyway, the other thing is there is a screen, like a piece of screen wire. Look, it just that's what it is. It's round, of course, but that may be clogged up. But they say it's easier. If you take them apart to try to fix them, then you'll probably have trouble with them. So, and it's only, I found this one for $16 on Amazon, so I decided to replace it and not keep fiddling around, you know. Here it is. Where is it? Right there. We'll put our gotta be able to work, but you know, it's actually okay for me to look through the camera too. Okay, here we go. I don't think I can be fully to this side. Yeah, now maybe I can show the work and still work. And be close enough to, yeah. Oh, it's coming out. Yeah, that's, I didn't want my, oh, it's full of food. And they tell you, you know, to unplug it when you disconnect and reconnect this. And I may do that just to make sure it doesn't jack things up. But, yeah, let's, now that I've got that loose, let's see. Yeah, so this hose pops in the bottom of it. So what I'm thinking, I want to blow that hose out. Well, let's get the old one off first, and then we'll see about that. You're not going to get shocked with this. It's protecting. It's in there in a way that you're not going to get shocked. So not too worried about that. These screws look to be all the same, but let's make sure. I'd rather it not be running whenever I disconnect that. Well, the ice maker's turned off, though. Water, of course, is turned off. So, and it's, from what I've seen in all the how-to videos, good old boys trying to help you. Doesn't matter which way this is, you know, you could flip it, but I made sure and didn't flip it. So, I'm going to do the same thing. And of course, my pen won't write on it. Well, I can see that those little notches are on the top. I'm not going to go run and get a marker. Okay, let's see. But I do want to, I think I'll unplug it as much as before I unplug that. There is going to be a little bit of water there. Okay. Gotta go get, go unplug it. Really unplug it while it's running, though, do I? So let's see. I'm gonna let it finish running, but it won't work to pull this water hose out of here. Out of here. Where'd it go? Get that out by my fingers, I'll be good. Let's see. Let's get that loose from there if I can. That's kind of sharp. Oh, I see. There's a paper towel. And a new camera over and over. Okay, let's see. That looks like it should probably stay on the, yeah, there's not a new one of those clips. Oh, yes, there is. Okay, so I'm going to get it out of the clip then. Get the hose out of the clip. I'm going to use my needle nose in reverse if I can to spread that open. Okay, now.
And I wanted to leave that connection on there until this thing quits running, then I'll unplug it and all that stuff. I'm gonna try to pull that out. I don't know if they pull out good or not. I'm gonna have to cut it. I think I'm gonna just have to cut it. Oh, do you push or pull that thing? I do not remember. I haven't messed with one of those in a long, long time. If it, you know, kind of scratches up the plastic pipe, then it wouldn't, well, I think it'd be better for it to be a brand new, it's long enough, isn't it?
Yep, it's long enough to,
cut it off. And I did bring my, I put a new blade in my utility knife earlier when I wanted to cut a box today, so I'm just going to cut it off about right there. Yes, I did get water all over the place. Oh, and I think I got some in my screw hole. Oh, well. That's why I got a paper towel. It's running way longer than I thought it would. Okay, so what I want to do, though, is I'm going to go around to the other side. And I'm going to try to blow air backwards through this, but I'm going to take this with me so that I can see if anything's coming out. About the air compressor around there, it's already. So let's get our camera.